नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम JBN डॉक्टर अनामिका अहरवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लेक्चर ऑन द सब्जेक्ट नेम ओपन सोर्स टेक्नोलॉजी एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे सेशन इज ओपन ऑफिस। These are the following heads which I have covered in this session: introduction of open office, history of open office, governance, naming, features, supported operating systems, what packages does openoffice.org come with, what special features does openoffice.org come with. Now let's start introduction of open office. This openoffice.org, that is OOO, commonly known as OpenOffice, is a discontinued open source office suite. It was an open source version of the earlier Start Office, which Sun Microsoft acquired in 1999 for internal use. Okay, so this OpenOffice included a word processor, spreadsheet, a presentation application, a drawing application in which you can draw, a formula editor like math functions, okay, and a database management application, that is base, okay. It's a default file format was the open document format, that is ODF and ISO IEC standard, which originated with openoffice.org. So it could also read a wide variety of other file formats with particular attention to those from Microsoft Office. Now the Sun Office sourced the OpenOffice suite in July 2000 as a competitor to Microsoft Office, which is releasing version 1.0 on 1 May 2002. And in 2011, Oracle Corporation, the then owner of Sun, announced that it would no longer offer a commercial version of the suite and donated the project to the Apache Foundation, right? So this Apache renamed the software Apache OpenOffice, and the other active successor projects include LibreOffice. The most actively developed the new office commercial only for Mac operating system. This openoffice.org was primarily developed for Linux, Microsoft Windows and Solaris, as we all use this MS Office in our Windows operating system, okay, for our documentation, presentation and for the database also. And this were distributed under the GNU Lesser General Public License version 3, that is LGPL, and the early versions were also available under the Sun Industry Standard Source License, that is SISSL. Now the history of OpenOffice. The OpenOffice.org XML file format, XML in a zip archive, easily machine processable. This was intended by Sun to become a standard interchange format for office documents to replace the different binary formats for each application that had been usual until then, right? So the Sun submitted the format to the Organization for the Advancement of Structured Information System Standards, that is OASIS, in 2002. And after that, it was adapted to form the Open Document Standard in 2005, which was ratified as ISO 26300 in 2006. Now, it was made OpenOffice.org's native formats from version 2 on. Many governments and other organizations adapted open document, particularly given there was a free implementation of it readily available. Now, after acquiring Sun in January 2010, Oracle Corporation continued developing OpenOffice.org and StarOffice, which is renamed Oracle OpenOffice, though with a reduction in assigned developers. Right? So, in September 2010, the majority of outside OpenOffice.org developers left the project due to concerns over Sun and then Oracle's management of the project and Oracle's handling to its open source portfolio in general to form the Document Foundation, that is TDF. This TDF released the fourth LibreOffice in January 2011, and this is most Linux distribution soon moved to. And in April 2011, Oracle stopped development of OpenOffice.org and fired the remaining Star Division development team. And later in June 2011, Oracle contributed the trademarks to the Apache Software Foundation. Now come to the governance. During Sun's sponsorship, the OpenOffice.org project was governed by the Community Council comprising OpenOffice.org community members. The Community Council suggested project goals and coordinated with producers of directives on long-term development planning issues. So, both Sun and Oracle are claimed to have made decision without consulting the council or in contravention to the council's recommendations, like leading the majority of outside developers, leaving the LibreOffice. This Oracle demanded in October 2010 that all council members involved with the Document Foundation step down. So, leaving the community council composed only of Oracle employees. Now, naming. The project and software were informally referred to as the OpenOffice since the Sun release. But since this team is a trademark held by OpenOffice, automatizing in Benelux since 1999, OpenOffice.org was its formal name. So, due to similar trademark issues, Rio de Janeiro company that owned that trademark in Brazil, the Brazilian Portuguese version of the suit was distributed under the name BrOffice.org from 2004 with BrOffice, right? So BrOffice.org, and then this BR.org being the name of the associated local non-profit from 2006, and this BR.org moved to LibreOffice in December 2010. And now supported operating systems. The last version, that is 3.4 beta 1, was available for IE32 version of Windows 2000, Service Pack 2 or later Linux, IE32 and X64, Solaris and OXX 10.4 or later, and the Spark version of Solaris. So these are the latest versions of OpenOffice.org on other operating systems, like IRIX, MIPS IV, and next is the Max 10.2 and 10.3, Windows 95, Windows NT, Windows 98, and Windows ME, that It is version 2.4.3. Now, what packages does OpenOffice.org come with? The following table compares the packages contained in Microsoft Office and those in OpenOffice.org. Like, if you are using the application word processor, then it is from it comes from the Microsoft Office, and the final output we get is OpenOffice.org. And spreadsheet is for Excel, and OpenOffice Calc and presentation package, PowerPoint, Impress, and the group work client is for Outlook, and this for none. And database management system access, there is no separate application, but built into OpenOffice.org is all the power of a full graphical user interface for the database client. Now drawing in that, we are not using the Microsoft Office, and for the drawing, DRAW, okay. This can be watched in Microsoft Office.org. Now, what special features does OpenOffice.org come with? First is Microsoft Office compatibility. It should be compatible, of course, that sometimes you have older version of Microsoft Word and your file is of higher version, then when you save that document, then it always ask for the compatibility, because that is not updated one. Okay, so same here for the Linux also, Microsoft Office compatibility you have to check, and then the one click export to PDF, export to flash.swf, and accessibility. Fifth is support for many interactive languages, open XML file format, now this is a question for practice, which menu bar selection would you access to open file? Thank you. This session powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jayoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.